What's up, Creed? Welcome to your Thursday warm-up demo video. We have our AMRAP by 6 minutes to start things off with. We got 30 seconds of a cardio choice, 10 good mornings, 10 and 10 dumbbell bent over row, and 8 dumbbell swings. So, cardio options today, we have jumping jacks. We could do high knees as well, or running in place. Then we have, lastly, a mountain climber option. We can get on the ground, work those shoulders as well as those core and hip flexor muscles, get that heart rate up. Then we have 10 good mornings here. All right, so with these good mornings, we're gonna drive those elbows back and behind, create some tension in our upper spine as well as the lower spine here, and notice how she drives her hips back on the same plane. They get driven backwards, not down. She's not going down, she's going backwards. She's hinging, it's not a squat. Keep those soft knees as well. Don't lock your legs out completely straight. Give it a nice knee bend here to absorb that weight. And then we have 10 and 10 dumbbell bent over rows. All right, so we'll grab our dumbbell here. 10 reps on the right side, 10 reps on the left side. So go ahead and begin that good morning motion, driving those hips back but not down with soft knees. And once you get to the bottom of that good morning, you're rowing that dumbbell to your hip. All right, after our 10 reps on that right side, we have 8 dumbbell swings. So we'll hold that dumbbell in a vertical position here, interlocking those fingers around one head, and she's still hinging. It's a faster good morning. It's an explosive good morning, all right? All three of these movements have good mornings in them, so we should get really, really good at this hinge movement, all right? Slow all the way to our kettlebell swings where we're doing them fast, all right? Then our workout, Thursday's workout, a lot of cardio, a little bit of strength here at the bottom. So you can start with part A or part B. Both will be 12 minutes, and you'll have a 2-minute rest in between when you switch. So part A, you're going 30 seconds on, 30 seconds off for 12 rounds, so that means 12 minutes. All right, you have a cardio choice. You can mix your cardio choice up. You can do running. You can do, if you have a rower, you can row. You can jump rope, do burpees, up downs, bicycle crunches, sit ups. You could do any type of cardio option where you're moving fast throughout that 30 seconds, and then you're able to rest for the 30 seconds. You'll go on and off for 12 rounds here. You'll end up with 12 total minutes. Then you'll rest for 2 minutes. You'll come down here to our EMOM by 12 minutes. So minute one, we have 5 and 5 dumbbell hang power cleans, trying to build to a moderate heavy weight today. And then we have 10 V-ups, 27 double unders, and or 81 single unders there, all right, with those three movements. So, shows you guys the cardio options, explain some other cardio options as well. You'll rest for 2 minutes, and then you have your EMOM by 12 here. You're going 5 and 5 with a dumbbell hang power clean, all right? Keyword is hang. She's only hinging back so her hand gets to the top of her knee, but not past her kneecap, all right? So it's a shorter range of motion than a power clean. She's coming to the top of the knee. She explodes up like she's jumping straight up. She shrugs, and then she catches and turns that elbow under to catch that dumbbell on her shoulder here with a nice high, good front rack position. Once she gets 5 and 5 on each arm, she'll drop down to the ground. After that minute is up, you have 10 V-ups on minute two here, 10 V-ups on minute two. So with these V-ups, hands are overhead and we're reaching for those shoelaces, trying to keep our legs as straight as we can, keeping those heels off the ground the entire time. If we have to, place those heels on the ground in between reps, explode from the bottom, touch the shoelaces, and come back down and rest, all right? Just like that for 10 reps. Then when you have minute three come around, you have 27 double unders or 81 single unders. So if you're trying to practice double unders but do not have a double under or do not have a speed rope or a jump rope, you can do penguin taps here. So we're really trying to jump high with these penguin taps. And each time you're in the air, when the feet are off the ground, you would tap your thighs twice. All right, then you land, you don't tap, you jump, you tap twice. All right, so that's good for practicing that mind to muscle connection with our double unders if you don't have a rope. If you do have a rope though and you wanna do single unders, or you can do ghost rope here. So just regular, kind of getting those feet off the ground a little bit, kind of like line hops there. All right, so 27 double unders, jumping higher, tapping those thighs, or 81 single unders with a rope or with ghost rope if you do not have one. All right, Creed, we'll see you guys next week.